Yeah, man!
Hello, my name is Miguel, and today I'm gonna make for you pork, broad bean, or butter bean, brown stew. So you're gonna need a 1 pound pork stew, a can of 300 grams butter beans, a stack of scallion, spring of thyme, a medium-sized onion or 2 small onions, piece of ginger, 8 garlic cloves, 1/2 of a scotch bonnet pepper, a small tomato, 1 tablespoon of dried basil and parsley, 1 teaspoon of fermented berries, 1 teaspoon of rosemary, 1 tablespoon of sea salt, 1 tablespoon of soy sauce, 1 teaspoon of browning jerk sauce, 1 teaspoon of oregano, 1 teaspoon of marjoram, 2 whole cloves, and 1/4 cup of cooking oil. Now, I'm gonna do the regular ads. Add 1, add 2. I'm gonna add the ingredients twice. As for the onion, just peel the outer leaf off, just the brown leaf. The first layer of the onions is strongest. And then slice it when you get your chance. 1/2 sliced onion on one side and 1/2 on the other side. The tomato, I'm gonna put it in add 2, but we're gonna add it while it stews. And the spring of thyme, add 2 as well. Well, we're gonna rinse off the thyme. Just peel the garlic and take outer leaf off, and then trim any brown spots you might see or any spoilage. All right, scotch bonnet pepper, we'll rinse that. As for the scallion, remove dying leaves and cut ends off, and the root end and the tip off. You just need a piece of ginger, say 1/4 inch piece of ginger, about the first index of your finger. Just peel the ginger. Now, this is rosemary. You need about 1 teaspoon of rosemary, grinded fine rosemary. Remember now, you can use any of these herbs fresh, just dice it fine. Basil, measure and add 1 tablespoon. Dried parsley, 1 tablespoon. As you see, I'm eyeballing it, but I know 1 tablespoon. And if you look properly, you can see that it's about 1 tablespoon. Teaspoon, dried pimento berries. All the things I just mentioned, put them 1/2 in each of the containers. That looks like the oregano. About 1 teaspoon of marjoram. For 2 solid whole cloves. Added to the containers, 1 in each container. I'm gonna rinse off the vegetables. The spring of thyme, we're just gonna add this thyme and add container 2, the ginger and add 1, and the tomato and the pepper in add 2. As for the scallion, just dice the scallion fine and divide it as well. These are the onion. I didn't dice or slice them as yet, so I did say slice earlier, so now I'm slicing it. Why we add the ingredients twice? In natural cooking, because you're using the herbs to flavor your stew, it's best if you add the ingredients twice to maximize flavor. If you don't want to add it twice, you can add it all 50 minutes near to the end. That will maximize flavor. The garlic now, just grind them fine equally in each container as well. If you don't have a grinder like this, you can mash it. If you saw some of my videos, I use a knife sometime and mash it to puree. Oh yeah, because if you add the ingredients too early, the flavor is going to evaporate out of the stew and it's going to make it fresh. Do as you see me doing, prepare, put this aside for later. This is pork stew. I bought this in the wholesale. It's kind of frozen, look fresh, meaning it's good, meaning it's not old. It's kept properly. It's kept frozen and stored properly. So therefore it won't spoil because it's stored properly. A lot of people do know that meat can last a very long time, maybe years, if it's kept properly. You need to cut the pork stew. Usually they come cut in stews, but sometimes stew pieces are big, so look at them properly and then cut about 2 inches pork chunks. I'm just going through, just looking, to be honest, this pork stew is clean and kind of like prepared properly when they were butchering the pig. You don't have no fat actually. Actually, I didn't see not one piece of fat. And this they say is the other white meat. And it is. Just add some water. With this, use some lime juice. Or you can use lemon juice if you don't. But recommend using lime juice. And just squeeze about one lime or half of a lime juice in it. Lightly rinse your pork stew. And then throw this water out. After that, just rinse it again with some fresh water. You see the difference with this and beef? I don't really like washing beef because of the water. You know, to me, you're washing out the flavor. But with this, there's no running because this is like pure meat. So throw that water off, and this is what you want. Put it aside. Now, put to eat pressure cooker. Oh, so that we won't forget, just measure and add a tablespoon and a half of sea salt. About a tablespoon between a tablespoon and a half. Just allow pressure cooker to dry out some. The stove's gauge is on 4, medium low. Just allow. Now, after 2 minutes, and there's no water in the pot, add 1/4 cup of cooking oil. I use coconut oil. I recommend that you use coconut oil. Just allow that to get hot for a couple minutes. Stove's gauge is on 4, medium low still. This is jerk sauce. Just measure and add 1/2 teaspoon and put it in add 2. Container, add 2. Seasoning container, add 2. Alright, so now after 2 minutes and the oil is hot somewhat, you can add and make sure the pieces, the pork stew pieces, are dry. It's not wet, you know, like water dripping water. Alright, so just add it to your pressure cooker pot. And kind of use a cooking spoon and kind of lay them. They're gonna be sticking somewhat, so you just gotta allow it. You just gotta allow it if it sticks. It's gonna stick, so just allow it. Alright, two between 3 minutes. Just kind of use your cooking spoon and kind of gently stir in your pork stew. Add the ginger, the chopped onions and scallions. Not the garlic yet, not the ginger, garlic, not the garlic yet, nor the herb. Alright, so stir fry that in for a couple seconds. Why we do this? Burning the onion kind of enhances the flavor as well. Natural cooking. Stove's gauge was on 4, so now kind of turn it up on 6, medium high. This is going to be the best pork stew you have ever ate. After a minute, add a garlic, mashed garlic. You don't want to add herbs now because they're going to burn and spoil your food and spoil the stew. So don't add the herbs now, just add the garlic and allow. Alright. After a minute, well, less than a minute, measure and add 1 teaspoon of browning. Alright, it's gonna be burning. It's gonna be burning, so kind of stir fry it quickly, kind of brown the pork stew pieces. Just take 20 seconds to do that, because you need to add the water quickly. So add 2.5 cups of water. For 1 pound of pork stew, we're using 2.5 cups of water. Measure and add 1 tablespoon soy sauce. Okay, stir in. And now would be the best time to add the herbs. That way you get the natural oil from the herbs. Do as you see me doing and kind of finish up this preparation part of for pressure cooking. Watch the rubber, make sure the rubber is on properly. Look at all the parts, make sure everything is on properly. Put on the pressure cooker's lid on properly. Put the nozzle on too as well. Some of these lids, the nozzle is on it. So you just allow. Once it starts to whistle, we're gonna time it. The stove gauge is on 4. You can turn it up somewhat if you want. But once it starts to whistle, we're gonna turn it back down on 4 and time it. Alright. Starts to whistle. Put your timer for 8 minutes. And the stove gauge is on 4, medium low. Make sure the stove gauge is on 4, medium low. And allow. And we're having our pork, butter beans, brown stew with parboiled rice. Alright. This is a can. Butter beans. So you use your can opener and can open it. I don't have a can opener right now, so excuse my knife. And if you do it my way, cut a wafer bean. Alright, look at this. This is how I believe the beans should look. But that's all I'm gonna say. Alright, so throw this syrup or whatever liquid this is off. Alright, throw that water off and then throw, on the running water, you just rinse it, throw just running fresh water, but not forcefully, you know, because you don't want to break the beans. So gently throw running fresh water over that and rinse it off, like this. Do it twice, 3 times, my lady. You put the can in away from you and be careful in the kitchen because you can get cut. 8 minutes, 9 minutes the most, but let it be 8 minutes. Just turn it off. If you're in a hurry, just run this part over water. Don't ever lift it up because that is the flavor escapes, in my opinion, until that part releases. Remember, don't ever lift it up. And then remove your pressure cooker to a cooler plate. This took some time, about 8 minutes or 10 minutes to cool. Once it's cooled, you just take the lid off easily. Pork is not tough. You can pressure cook easy or in a shorter time. Test it. I'm trying to find one with mostly beef, meat. Alright, so test it. See, it's very... It's done, it's tender, it's tenderized. This is a saucepan that I fried some chicken in earlier, so it only enhances the flavor. I'm just adding it to the saucepan. You can use the same pressure cooker pot if you don't want the saucepan. You don't have to transfer it. Once you do that, turn the stove back on and put the stove's gauge on 4, medium low. Add ingredients number 2, or season add number 2. Alright, put the pans lid on and allow. Alright, now would be a good time to dice and add the tomato. It's not gonna be hot or spicy if you use the old scotch bonnet pepper, but I'm just gonna use that. So cover it and allow. Put the stove's gauge is on 4, medium low. Visit JamaicaDinners.com for the recipe. Subscribe, like, share. Try this meal and give us feedback. 15 minutes. I didn't open it within the time. With these type of natural cooking, you have to keep the lid on. Open it every minute and, in my opinion, flavors escape. So you just make a one stir, see where you're at, and cover it and allow. To be honest, it's because I'm showing you why I'm opening it. I would have just allowed it straight through the entire time. 30 minutes. Later, this is what it looks like. Remove the time stick. This would be our best time to remove the time stick because it splashes and it burns and messes stove up. That's it, kind of, every all it's done its job. Add a pepper. You can use a whole pepper. Because with pork, you know, pork come like turkey's neck. It kind of suck up the flavor of whatever is cooking. All right, stove gauge is on 4. Allow. Pot's laid on properly and allow. 40 minutes later, this is what it looks like. All that water now is building. The water evaporates and leaving just the gravy now. You see the gravy start forming and building. And the pepper, just watch the pepper. We'll add the beans next. 45 minutes later, see it's kind of gravy thickening. This is pork stew now, so you gotta stir it gently. If you stir it too rough, it could break the pork up. It's not tenderized soft enough, it's just right, but you don't want to serve people mashed up pork stew. So add about 300 grams of butter beans. If you don't want to use the butter beans from the can, you can pressure cook, wash the beans in properly, and pressure cook the butter beans for 18 minutes. That's good in 6 cups of water. So you add that, stir it in somewhat, and cover it. And we're not going to use any ketchup. I want just a pure pork flavor. Stove gauge is on 4. Allow. It's been 50 minutes. Alright, so you just stir that in. Alright, see it's thickening, it's thickening. See it? The color is right. Once the stew, gravy starts to stick to the pot's bottom somewhat, that's a sign to say it's ready. The gravy is thick and nice. The beans are just right, they're not soft. And you want to stir your pot gentle, because you don't want to break the beans in either. So that's it, finish. Aroma, you can smell it, it's original. So you just cover it until you're ready to serve. So just before serving, just give your pot a couple stirs, a few stirs, and then take a scoop of this delicious pork butter beans brown stew. Visit jamaicadinners.com for the recipe. Subscribe, like, share, try this meal, and give us a feedback. This is pork broad beans or butter beans, or you cannot use any beans, brown stew. Try this meal yourself and give us a feedback. This recipe is in Jamaica Dinners cookbook 1 or 2, I'm not sure. So this is pork, butter beans, brown stew. Subscribe, like, share, and give us a comment. Pork, butter beans, brown stew. Looks delicious, doesn't it? Again, I'm gonna cross boundaries and sample this meal for you or with you while you're watching. While you are watching. Ah, look at these beans, man. This is the brand I like to use. I know somebody gonna say it's a chemical I use. I know it's some kind of chemical they use. Alright, so this is our beef. Sorry. This is our pork. Butter beans. Brown stew. It's fresh. And nice. Single flavor, like all the ingredients that I put together come up with one nice flavor, one delicious flavor. Like if when you mix lemonade, you put the lemon with the sugar and then the water, and then you mix it and you get a one flavor. This is what this tastes like right now. It doesn't have an outstanding flavor as when I do beef, but the flavor is like all the flavors inside of the pork. So it's like it's juicy in the pork. It's just a nice dinner eat. And two, the best eat for this is not to eat right away. If you cook and let it sit for like 3 hours before serving and then you warm it up again, it's gonna be even juicier. All the flavor, all the oil, the herbs in the oil in the herbs and the nutrients from the vegetables all just mix in the stew and give it one flavor. The pork is tender. Even the skin part is flavorful. Usually I don't eat this part whenever I eat this. I just eat just the meat part, but I eat a couple pieces of the skin part and that's it. Gravy is just right. Salt is just right. The herbs, poor proportions are just right. Even the color of it look right. It kind of have this reddish, like when you roast pork, like roast pork. Yeah. I enjoyed this meal. To be honest, I don't really eat pork much. The only time I eat pork is when my friend downtown, Rodney, you hear me talk about him all the while. Him love pork. Only when him cook, he will eat and him serve it for dinner and I'll eat it. But I don't normally cook as much. But I must say, this is flavorful. For all you pork lovers out there, try this recipe with the herbs and you will enjoy it. And give us back a feedback. Look at that. Look how juicy this look. Try this meal yourself and give us a feedback. You saw me cook it from raw to a meal. The 8 minutes is very sufficient. Right around the board. I don't think it don't really matter how much. If you are cooking more, it's the same 8 minutes. Like if you are cooking 4 pounds of pork stew, probably go 10 minutes the most, but you don't need to cook it much. I mean pressure cook it much. And if you don't have a pressure cooker, you can boil it and add a small amount of water, because the same Rodney I was telling you about gave me a tip. If you cook the pork, you don't even have to add water, because pork tend to give off a lot of water. It give off like it's sweat water. Can't say why, but it does. So you could just put the pork and cover it properly and just leave it on a medium steam, and then the water will build. And then just cook it like that and watch it and then it until it tenderizes, and then you cook it down. Because me can't bother with them long cooking, why you don't really see me doing it. You're the siren. Butter beans or broad beans. If you don't want to use that, to be honest, it's kind of new or different, because most people don't add it. Butter beans or broad beans to this. Only oxtail, but it can work. I'm sure people doing it. You can use Irish potato, just dice them fine and add it 8 minutes to the end. You can use carrot only, just add them at the end. Look at that, look at the skin part. Women would have loved this meal, man. Women love pork like what? Look at that. And when I ate this meal too, my stomach was very calm. It was very, I didn't hear not one grumble a bit. Not one grumble. And normally, my mouth is watery. My mouth get watery whenever I eat pork. With this, it didn't at all. And when Rodney cook it too, it don't get watery. Or like jerk pork or so forth, like on roadside or so. I don't really eat anything there. Unless Rodney jerk it. Alright, see you. Bye.
Yeah, man!